Sturridge looking to turn supplier this time to Wijnaldum. Firmino wants it, so does Lallana! What a strike! And what a fantastic goal by Adam Lallana!
And we're back with Sense of Pitches, everybody!
Woo!
Yay!
Dilly ding, dilly dong.
All right, right.
Suck a dick, Reverend.
So eh? Leicester
champion, ke? Huh? Budak lucky je one season.
Okay.
It's shit.
Are you done?
Taimangs are not here today.
Remember that time when they lost to Burnley?
Hey, not me, fucker. I was in the States.
Okay.
I was in the States, that's
anyways,
why.
Anyways, we are back after a 1 week break. And
yeah. Congratulations to Henry. He escaped unemployment.
Woo!
Sort of.
With an internship, so.
Sort of.
Can I put
CK
myself
is still
back in
unemployed.
There. Fuck you, I am unemployed.
Ah, CK employed.
Yeah, he's but the sort of level now. Is not as high as Henry. Think what? About it.
Wow.
Just well, fuck it. You. Let's move on.
I didn't say anything, huh? I didn't say anything.
Okay. Right. So let's move on. Yeah. Let's focus on football, not our personal lives right now.
Which thank you.
Just as sad as football. Anyways, very interesting developments that came about from last week's matches. So some of them very, and some of them are actually quite good. And so
yeah.
A lot of goals.
That's what I'm happy about this week.
Without further ado, let's dive into this. First match that we're going to be talking about last week is from the EPL itself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And it was a match that both Johan and I fucking enjoyed.
For the very first time.
Why, United? are you happy that United lost, sir?
Yes, I'm happy. Yeah.
No. Johan enjoyed it because he actually got to watch it at the Mamak with us for the first time.
Yeah, for the very first time.
Then he WhatsApp me. He said, CK, why are you not coming? I was like, fuck, I got dinner. Like,
why, you never asked me?
Because you were busy
emceeing as well. Escaping unemployment.
at least this one got me paid really fast, so I got money to use really.
Damn, a lot of money, right?
No.
Anyways.
Can we move on to the match?
Guys,
all this embarrassment.
So the City United match, it was a 2-1 win to City at Old Trafford, and honestly it was a good game.
Yeah, it was a good game.
So Pep finally got his tactics.
They played really well.
And honestly, it's because we've talked about this.
Yeah,
before,
we talked about
how City is fucking scary.
Yeah, we came to the conclusion that hey, look, this is a City without Aguero. If Aguero were in the picture, it could have been a 4-1 or 5-1 victory.
So I wanted to place a bet against Izham that one day.
Yeah,
in the
but
World
then
like,
but then we both
but we both chose City.
Yeah.
Fuck. Yeah.
This is the first time I see United supporters so quiet. You know. Hey, mana kamu semua?
No, but okay.
Mana kamu semua?
Okay, to be fair to United, United played really well the game.
They played really well.
Okay. Zlatan especially.
Mm-hmm. Wait, where's Pogba though in this situation?
Pogba was actually quite quiet.
He's a rugby player today.
No.
Well.
Pogba didn't deliver.
He tried to play her down. Oh my gosh.
He tried to play her down that day.
He didn't play well. No one detected his presence in the second.
You know why not? Because he's wearing new shoes.
No, the thing is, right? Both you have.
Hey, Adidas. No, I'm not kidding. You know, Adidas actually came out with a pair of shoes for Pogba. It's red and white.
Yeah.
And that is only for his match in the Manchester Derby.
Well, they sponsored the deal when he
Well, good luck.
You know, his presence like Ellen.
That's true.
Not there.
Oh boy. But okay. In that match, it was the thing is Pogba's presence wasn't felt at all to a point where both Johan and I were watching and we were like, "Hey, who was subbed out in the second half?" We were both asking each other that.
Oh, you guys
like,
didn't even know then.
No, we thought
no,
it was
we
Pogba
thought
that
Pogba
was
subbed
out.
Oh shit. He wasn't
that was
there.
How bad he was.
Fuck.
Because we thought he wasn't present on the field.
And then when
we saw his number come up.
When we saw him, we were like,
number 6? Oh, the fucker's still here.
Yeah, and we were like, oh, wait, it was Mkhitaryan that was subbed out.
Oh, yeah. But anyways, this City, right? Like we've been talking about the past few podcasts, it's really scary to see how they are playing.
Basically,
they were very fast. United couldn't react at all.
Basically, all boils down to this, yeah. City's passes are fucking on point.
And I tell you this, it's Pep Guardiola doing his magic here.
Yeah, it is Guardiola doing, but
it is.
If I may argue, if we didn't put Fellaini, Lingard and Mkhitaryan as a start, maybe this wouldn't have been the case.
And if I may argue, Blin is a piece of shit.
He has always been a shit.
He was a piece of shit in this match.
He was a piece of shit in Holland as well.
Blind as well.
I mean, if you saw the first goal, the one where De Bruyne just pushed away the ball then just sprinted in.
He didn't expect him to come and...
No, the thing is, as a defender, you're supposed to be, well, composed. You're supposed to be expecting the unexpected in that situation.
You have to cut him some slack because he is not naturally a defender. He's not naturally a centre back. He was a centre defensive midfielder.
He has always been a DM.
Yeah, he was never a DM.
Well, you just because Van Gaal who made him play in that position.
Yeah, look at Lucas when he plays centre back for Liverpool.
But then I can argue back again.
Don't bring back.
We will get to Lucas later. Don't worry. Fucker. I have a lot of time for that. But to be fair, if you want a counter back, I can also say that if Mourinho knows that he's a natural DM, why still play him as a CB?
Exactly.
Because it's Mourinho.
Because there's Fellaini, a defensive midfielder.
Goes back to my argument. He shouldn't have started Fellaini. What was the point of putting Fellaini there? You know City is fast. Their passing is on point. They play position.
And they should have
But you also know that Mourinho is a stubborn fucker.
True. But then I also felt that they should have started.
That's my point.
Right. And they should have started Mata also.
I think Mourinho's kind of play is usually they like, you know, central defensive, the midfielder, right? It's usually huge.
Or tall. Yes.
At tall.
But that was not his style of play in the first two games, you know.
Neither is it Blin.
Well, to be fair, he
put players like Rooney, Herrera, Mata. Mm. Why weren't they playing?
Okay, experiment.
And Mkhitaryan always came in as a sub. Yes. And you can see Mkhitaryan is struggling. If he starts with the team, he's struggling to fit in.
And if you want to say, so you're happy about that. If you want to look at it, yeah, Herrera couldn't do anything. Herrera could not play against that Manchester City defense.
But he played well in the past 2-3 games.
Yeah, just
at the start.
Yeah, but you have to remember, yeah.
City defense, they are bulky.
Yeah. Herrera cannot do.
Herrera is skinny.
But I just want to say that even though City completely outclassed us, I acknowledge that. Okay, they were the better team, but the way United responded, the way they put their enthusiasm, their fighting spirit, that was not something you would have seen if
Van Gaal
was still in charge.
Yeah. If Van Gaal was
fair enough, that's fair enough.
If Van Gaal was still in charge, that morale would not be there. So God knows what Mourinho told them in the dressing room in the first half.
I think it's more towards the Mancunian pride, you know, they want to bring the Manchester is red kind of thing. So when it comes to the derby, they come in with an extra momentom. Yeah, that's why I believe
still lost at Old Trafford.
And be honest, City, they played damn well in the first half, but you could see how that kind of playing style took a toll on them in the second half.
Oh, definitely.
They were so tired in the second half. I can't count the number of times we stole the ball from them.
And you have to remember, in the second half when we watched the game, we saw how City was actually lagging behind Manchester United already.
Yeah, we were analysing the match and we realised in the first half, City rarely passes back to the keeper.
Right.
Because they didn't have to, they had the luxury of doing it around midfield.
Yeah,
but in the second half, they slowed down, they realised they had to pass back to the keeper, they had to play more of a around kind of...
Possession play.
More circulation.
At the very least, City did not park the bus.
Yeah, that's one good thing about that.
That's why it was a nice derby match, because no one was parking the bus.
I think
was going all out.
I think if you ask me, right, Guardiola is not the type of guy that would employ the park the bus tactic. If he could score more goals, he would score more goals just to finish the game off.
Yes.
That's Guardiola.
Yep.
Alright, fair enough. Alright, so that's all about City United. It was a good derby game. The end. Done. Enough for Manchester. Fuck Manchester.
Nada. Goodbye.
Let's move on to London.
Right, let's go to London.
No, actually not London.
Your favourite team?
Stoke. Yeah, my favourite team, Stoke City Rugby Club.
Hey, you're a supporter of Spurs, aren't you?
Exactly.
I'm just glad we're not talking about any Arsenal
Premier League
matches.
I saw the picture, man.
Oh, yeah. Thanks, Yuan, for the fucking Photoshop.
I edit it, man.
You edit la. Who else la? Okay, anyway, Stoke City versus Tottenham Hotspurs. Yuhan.
No, this is a match worth mentioning. This is Stoke City's third consecutive defeat.
Yay!
Woo! The good side of Tottenham, but he went to
Shaqiri
the
out of the club in January.
I just need to mention this. They have conceded 10 goals in just 3 games.
Fuck.
And if you watch the 4 goals, they weren't...
Bro, 4 games.
Yeah, what? 4 games. 4 games.
But the
this
first game they draw. They draw against Middlesbrough.
0-0. One.
Yes. Please, I know my facts. I've been doing the rundown.
Ooh, you must need it today.
I have a job.
Hey, I have a legit reason now.
No, but coming back to the point, Stoke's defense, right? If you look at the game, right, they were basically sleeping. It was non-existent.
What happened to Ryan Shawcross though? He's usually the rock behind
I have no idea.
He usually be the fucker that
maybe
pushes
it was
people around.
Just one of those games where they just had a bad day. The whole team just felt fucking icky.
But three days
doing this consistently.
Yeah, three games in a row, dude.
Well, I guess we know where the first manager that's going to get sacked this season is going to come from.
Ooh, what a call.
But yeah. It's quite
damn
it's
dangerous.
Is it Mark Hughes' problem?
Oi, oi.
Or is it the players' problem?
I believe it's
I think it's
tactical.
The players, because
tactical.
One thing for sure, there were the last goal, especially when Kane scored, it was a through ball from the right flank. So the ball just went past Shea Given, and then the defenders were just looking at the ball passed by them.
Technically, it's the fourth goal coming in. So.
Yeah,
it's the fourth goal, lah.
Everyone was like, "Fuck it, lah, just give it another one, lah." You know.
Honestly, for a team like Stoke, they're not
because
the time to be like that.
Kane
even
has
in the
a gold route.
What happened to the tough Stoke? You get what I mean?
Yeah.
Tough
Stoke. No. Like legit though. Like we remember Stoke from last season, and we can remember how they weren't really the most. Okay, they weren't the best team either, but they wouldn't give up just like
they
that.
They would still hold their ground, lah. Basically.
Yeah.
I believe what's happening here is just. It's just the start of the season. You cannot say anything. Some teams start like shit. Some teams start well.
I think,
you know,
after this we might not be able to say that though, because it's already game number 4 and
we
I
want to go relegation.
I don't think anyone can afford to say it's the start of the season.
But to be fair, I think Mark Hughes will be able to keep them away from the relegation zone.
You know what I think Mark Hughes needs to do?
What?
He needs to bench Alan.
We don't mind.
It's not our problem now.
It's not our problem now.
He could have been our problem if he stayed
like
in Liverpool.
He does in Liverpool.
That's because he stayed in Liverpool for so long.
I think like if they put Charlie Adams instead, they won't succumb to this kind of.
Yeah,
another
I agree.
That came from Liverpool as well.
I for only a season. For
same
only
thing,
a season.
Same thing.
I agree with your point because I think Charlie Adams is the type of player who can
tough,
be.
Strong.
Yes, he's a very tough. He's Scottish, but he's a true Brit, lah. You know, he's very, very like
very buff,
firm, stand their ground kind of guy, and
like
and
to fuck around people.
Yes, and he can and he can try from distance.
Yeah.
He's what I like about Charlie Adams is he would fucking try. Stoke, right? The only person who can try other than him is either Ibrahim Hafalai. I don't know where the fuck he is now. Bojan.
Exactly.
Huh.
Where the fuck is he? Where
Bojan?
Is Mark Muniesa?
Yeah, exactly.
Guys, we should start a new segment. Where are these players now?
Bojan and Shaqiri.
Lost players, yes, I like that. Alright, so that's it though. I mean, honestly, at the end of the day, if Stoke doesn't buck up,
well,
they're gonna be relegated.
I think it was because of Son came back for Spurs as well.
Son, yes.
The whole momentum just drive them up.
Son is a speedy player.
Yeah,
Son is a speedy player. Mm. And this is what happens when you get paced over a physical team.
Yeah, when you see when Spurs was playing in Liverpool, right, it was like, you know, struggle still. The team is not complete.
Yes.
In that sense.
Yeah.
So you're saying Son is their glue. Son is like
their not their glue.
Not their glue.
They're given an extra. You know how when you have something that is
they
very.
They could rely on somebody
yes.
else.
Son is like the salt to our French fries. Spurs French fries.
Okay.
Alright. Saw the metaphor or not?
Okay.
See, I'm just gonna point
see,
out.
See, the thing is, fries would taste good.
Shut up.
But if you add extra salt to it, right, it'll be taste better.
Shut up.
Okay, you know
it's
what?
It's a good analogy, la fucker.
You know what? I'm just gonna give you a whole bowl of fries filled with salt, lah.
Okay. Hey, fuck you. Good. I didn't say a lot of salt, okay? I said a pinch. Fucker.
You didn't say a pinch, man.
Yeah, but I'm gonna take this with a pinch of salt, lah.
Alright, so
what the fuck, man,
I just want to point out
I don't
out
see
that
you for a week and this is what happens to you, eh?
I just want
to
point out that I did not even talk much in that talk set because fuck Spurs. Anyways, next up we have the West Ham and the Watford game.
Shite
again,
defending.
West Ham, similarly, this is their second consecutive defeat.
Poor defending.
Despite Dimitri Payet returning to
and game. This is about
and poor defending.
This is something to say, yeah. This is West Ham's second game in their new home ground.
But yes. Mikhail Antonio scored a very nice goal. Michael Antonio scored a very nice goal.
Sure,
okay,
which
good goal aside, his celebration though.
Fucking worm.
Did you see what he did? Like
no. I think someone
like
was controlling
fucking
him.
Magic cup or the
No. If you play FIFA enough, you can do that also. So
FIFA 17 come out already.
The manager,
demo.
The demo was.
But
actually
I feel
Payet
too
okay.
much.
Why?
Payet's Rabona was amazing.
Mm.
Yeah, I know it was amazing.
That Rabona
but don't you think
was
it was
sex.
A bit overdone.
It was just like.
It's like, was
no,
that
okay,
appropriate?
Okay, now, come back to this. My question would be now, if you can play such beautiful football, right, why the fuck did you lose to Watford?
Well, Watford
hey,
came back.
It's the same thing. If you can play such beautiful football, why the fuck did you lose to Burnley?
We never said we played
play good football that day, okay?
We played play shit football that whole game, okay? Burnley played well.
All right, all right.
But we talk about West Ham's defense, basically same thing as well. I think Slaven Bilic is still trying to fine tune.
Yeah.
Especially after he lost Tompkins to Crystal Palace.
Yeah,
that's true. I mean, you could see how all over the place they were.
Tompkins was the rock for West Ham.
I think the culprit in this game was Sam Byram. Because
he's still young.
He's 22 years old.
Yeah, he's still young.
And somehow he was linked to Arsenal.
Somehow.
I like Izham's face just change when he says Arsenal. Don't shut up. That's for me, man.
Somehow he was linked to Arsenal, and then there's Masuaku at left back as well. Masuaku was from Olympiacos. So you can tell how much he's gonna fit in.
There's a shift. There's such a huge difference in league, you know.
But give credit to West Ham. Their attacking options are actually quite interesting. Right. Zaza aside, if you don't give him a penalty, it's fine. Okay, Lanzini, you have Lanzini, you know.
Yeah, Baye.
And good thing they sold Ana Valencia to Everton, because he was not contributing at all to West Ham as well.
It was like a good last minute decision to go throw him away. He wanted Champions League football, what the fucker.
But then we didn't get to see Carroll much though.
Oh yeah, what happened to him?
He's still there.
And there was, I checked the Facebook page, there was apparently a lot of criticism on Mark Noble's performance.
Which is very rare to see.
Yeah, which is very rare. I'm not quite sure why.
Maybe perhaps that game was an off.
Was there something wrong with Slaven Bilic's tactic on that day? That, you know.
To be honest, right, his tactic so far has been very weird, you know.
Because this season.
For this season.
You see his defense, right? He plays kind of like a five, back five, but with two wing backs up.
Oh
so
shit.
So it's like a diamond
three.
Kind
it's
of.
It's like a 3-5-2 style of play or 3-4.
It's like a 3-5-2 kind of play.
It's just that it's a bit different
weird
kind of arrangement. So
which could,
quite weird.
Which could be the cause of the problem, because, you know, if you keep on employing tactics that are very, very uncomfortable for a player, this is what's going to happen, because the player is not is very unsure of what's happening in and around the pitch. Now, I'll give you an example of. It's a different sport, but it's football, American football. There's so much work put into. No, I'm just putting it. Shut the fuck up! I'm gonna put it in, okay?
No, sucker.
If you think about it, right? There's so much tactics put into one route itself, one play, okay, for a defender as well. So if you tell him you have to take care of this one side only, he will take care of this one side only. But if you let the person go, but the person behind is gone, then you're fucked already. You still have to run back. So in the end, I think it's more towards rigidity of a team. Like West Ham was too rigid in their tactics.
Thank
so
you for that inspiring analysis. Let's
you're welcome. So Friday night,
that's with that being said, that means that West Ham has a team that's not really that versatile.
Yes.
In terms of play style.
Yes. I mean, Payet, where do you employ him all the time? Wing. What else? Mikel Antonio, where is he? Wing. If you put him centre midfield, can run or not? Cannot what?
Can straight up.
Ah fuck lah. Still gonna run to a defender,
run,
right?
You cannot run, man.
Still run to defender, right?
You cannot run lah.
Fuck.
You know, speaking about versatile, how's Rooney?
Hey, what? Hey, pass the talk set already.
All right. So,
Liverpool. Except you, Lucas, I'm disappointed in you.
Johanna, I'm cutting out this next talk set.
Fuck,
but anyway, still gonna talk about it just to entertain Henry and CK. Next is the game where Liverpool, amazingly, surprisingly, I didn't know they were.
I agree with Izham. Amazingly.
I didn't know they were able
to
get this.
It was a fucking miracle that I get to see something so beautiful come out of Liverpool.
Yeah, their 4-1 win against Leicester. Henry, CK, take it away.
Okay, the first goal, right? I didn't know what was going on. I was just like, wow, Milner run. Wow, Milner pass. Wow, Fabinho was caught. I'm like, what the fuck happened?
Yeah, then he jinxed it afterwards. And he's like, wow, I didn't know Liverpool can play so well. Then suddenly Lucas make
no
wonderful mistake. Yeah?
No, it was second goal first, right?
Yeah,
second goal first. Then Lucas did the unthinkable. No, actually, no. To be fair, right, it was Mignolet's fault.
It was Mignolet's fault.
You don't pass out wide so deep, you know, when you have high pressure. You clear the fucking ball away. So stupid.
Instead of clearing it to the front, he passed it sideways.
Yeah, why the fuck?
Knowing that there were Leicester players still there.
Who the fuck does that?
Well, Mignolet lah.
Apparently, Brazilian scared of Japanese lah. So Okazaki just came and as a fucking.
Yeah.
He's not a fucking sumo size lah. Seriously.
But fucking, seriously.
Fucking hell, man.
But, to be fair. Yeah,
exactly. Even Lucas, he is clear. The worst that can happen is he
deflect, go back out.
Correct. No, okay. Correct.
Guys, to be fair to Minole, I mean,
there's no fairness to Minole, okay?
Hey, he made a good save.
Minus that blunder. He did play well.
Yeah, he did play well.
I was telling Henry, this guy cannot punch like shit in this game.
He get punched lah, but he won't. Yeah,
he cannot fucked up. But if he goes to the sub, he'll never come out.
Oh, yeah, fucker got the nosebleed and a cut eyebrow. I'm like, fucker, what are you trying to prove? Oh, I'm so sorry for letting that goal just now. Let me just cut my face up for a little bit just to gain some pity.
Can you tell me why Lucas was playing centre back?
Lovren had a training injury.
Yeah. Oh my god. His eye was swollen. Fuck. It was just really bad.
He couldn't even see.
Yeah. It was that bad.
So he had to be subbed off.
Sako, of course, still has the problem.
No,
we all don't know what
the
problem
is. I think Sako's gonna come back and play anytime soon. Really.
Is he in the under 23 squad?
No, he's training now with the full team.
Okay, fine. That's good news. That's good news.
Good news for Liverpool, at least, you know.
Now, in that case, right, I actually don't blame Klopp for this, because there is an article stating that Sako has been like this even since in PSG, which is why he left PSG in the first place. So, Klopp employing this to Sako is not a bad thing, you ask me. Yeah.
Can we talk about Leicester? This is surprising.
Leicester was shite that day,
like,
man.
Shite, man.
Yeah, shit.
Honestly,
shite.
It's just
really bad.
Mane destroying the whole defense because
I agree with
too
him.
Fast.
And Milner as well. Milner made some key passes.
Yeah, that's the thing. Mane actually just okay. Thing is about Leicester's defense, like, if you notice, they're not really the fastest defense.
Yeah, Robert Hoof can't run.
Yeah,
Christian Fuchs can't run.
When going up against a team like that, they're not able to respond well.
Leicester's defense is very bulky, and that makes them very slow as well. Okay.
Yeah, exactly.
Imagine Liverpool to play Benteke instead of.
Now we are fucked, lah. We are fucked.
We are literally fucked because there's two fucking giants in there.
We can't do shit.
And you put a fucking giant to play with them.
But Sturridge. But I want to point out Sturridge here. I think he didn't play well at all.
Yeah, he didn't play well.
Apart from the assist that he did. That was it. I mean, he had so many chances to score a goal, but you know, like, back in his day, he could have placed the ball far. The first attempt, right? He could have placed the ball far to the far post. There could have been an easy goal for him. I don't know why the fuck he must score and shoot straight to the keeper.
Yeah, like Benteke. I think Benteke put an influence into them. Or Balotelli, I'm not sure.
True,
I think it's Balotelli.
Then second goal also, he could have chipped it up
Benteke,
the keeper. I don't even know why
Balotelli
he's going to go
scored two goals already.
Exactly. Like, what the fuck is going on? That's why I was like, Henry.
Fuck lah.
Balotelli scored two goals in the first game.
Do you guys want to do a shout out to Lallana?
Oh, Lallana.
Oh my god, Lallana, I want to kiss you right now for making that sex goal. Such a fucking beautiful goal. You know, right? I thought it was like the game is going to be settled already, like, okay? The game is going to be like 2-1. That's it. Motherfucker comes out of nowhere and scores that fucking goal.
Boom!
It's like, hey, masuk. Boom! And then when he went there, I was just like, oh my god!
But it was surprising to see that Klopp didn't play Coutinho in this game.
Coutinho was unfit.
Yeah, but still.
True.
Okay, are you guys done your chat?
I mean,
okay, just mark my words, we might lose the next game.
No, I really want to see you next game.
We're going against Chelsea. I tell you, right, we got no chance.
Okay, right, we'll go into Chelsea. That later. The way at the end. But now,
sorry, CK, fuck no.
As for now, we're done with the Premier League section. Okay, we're not talking about Arsenal today.
Hooray.
Okay, we won 2-1. That's it, done. Okay, Arsenal won 2-1.
Fuck you, lucky Chibai. Fucking put a French bastard to lie down on the floor. I was like, yes, fucking draw. Which might have been top 4, you know, Liverpool. But this fucker had to fall down. Oh, penalty, please help. So let's move on.
Well, to rebut on your statement,
Giroud is only good in FIFA.
To rebut on your statement, Arsenal has been having a very lucky week.
Yes, I know, fucker.
Alright, so now we're gonna go into the Spanish league, okay?
Yay! Ole! Ole!
And we're gonna go into the best game of the week, Barcelona and Deportivo Alaves.
I have no idea what Luis Enrique was thinking.
Well, I think he wanted to trash Rodgers.
It's obvious he was overconfident.
He overconfident.
He
placed a second rate team, you know, into the game. I mean, besides Neymar, there, Turan.
Fucking Jasper Silisson. Oh my god, why the fuck is he?
I don't
what
like
the fuck
him,
is the striker again? Alcacer.
Oh, Paco Alcacer.
Yeah, but I agree with Henry though. Jasper really didn't feel like he was part of the team.
You asked me, right? When they announced him, I'm like, why the fuck would you want him?
Why didn't he play Ter Stegen? I still don't understand.
because Luis Enrique is stupid.
Why? The second,
a bit lah.
He's the next Neuer. He was dubbed the next Neuer, you know.
And the second could have had a chance to come to Liverpool, but no,
he wants to warm the bench in Barcelona.
So this is Sense of Pitches, everyone, where we all talk about shit about players that don't come to our own.
Come from Liverpool, yes, or go to Liverpool.
Almost every single player who doesn't come to Liverpool will be a victim.
Fuck you guys, lah.
But back to the Barcelona game. Honestly, Johan, you saw how the highlights were. They were shit.
I watched the highlights.
Literal shit from Barcelona.
It was very uncharacteristic of Barcelona to allow so much space, especially at the back four. And it's a problem for them, you know.
It could be because the lack of pace that they are suffering now, because Dani Alves has left and gone to Juventus.
You look at the justifications behind the purchases that they've made in recent years.
Right.
A lot of the centre backs that they are buying, a lot of the defenders they're buying, were intended as replacements for their first team regulars.
Right, yes, right,
that's correct.
Right.
They fielded these players, you know. They didn't perform, you know. Isn't it a warning sign for Barca?
Yeah, it could be a warning sign for
Barca. It's a warning sign for Barca.
It could make them go back down to where they were.
I mean, as I've said before, like, I think we're approaching that shift of what's it called, generations, where we're gonna see Messi, players like Ronaldo, all of them out.
I'm actually suggesting that we are already in that generation at the start of it.
We are at the start of
CK
it.
Has a point.
This is Enrique being confident. This is Enrique overconfident.
So he
took them out. They didn't play him.
He was being
overconfident. They didn't play them.
Okay, say for example, Enrique was not overconfident. He played his first team regulars. How many more years do these players have?
I mean, they could have won that match. Starting off. We are talking about them losing in this game, right?
That's true. In the terms of long run.
Oh my god.
Juan just went, okay.
Oh shit.
Can we keep this in the log so next time anytime that happens,
no,
right? But just to keep Juan down to earth, this is back again.
Right, guys are overdoing
guys,
it. I was
guys.
Clearly talking about a long term perspective.
Yeah, I know, I understand
what
you're saying.
About this match alone.
Because what we are talking about is this first-rate team losing to a second-rate team.
Yeah.
We are talking about that, right?
But then this first-rate team themselves did not field their best team, so...
Exactly.
It's their own fault.
But, yeah, exactly. It's
probably because they wanted to save their
team
want to
be
Champions League
champions.
Hey, please, the game was on Saturday? Was it Saturday or Sunday?
Same thing.
Yeah.
Same thing.
I mean, you only have that much buffer time for Champions League.
Exactly, so you put them to rest. I mean, give them a rest.
Put them to rest, can also. Put Messi first.
Why you want to put Suarez?
Don't put Suarez. Bring him back to Liverpool first.
But then again, I don't understand why they signed Paco Alcácer.
He
only made one strike, by the way.
Yeah, that to me was a mystery as well. Now, he's only 21 or 22 years old this year. So, I think it's more of a long-term replacement. But if you ask me, why do you have to buy Paco Alcácer when you have Mune?
Yeah. Mune trapped.
Mune went to Valencia, you know.
Huh?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Basically, they did an exchange deal. So I don't understand what's going on either.
Luis Enrique, you're being stupid, basically. No, honestly, Mune is good. You saw how he played in the King... No, sorry. It was the King's Cup. Copa del Rey. He played so well.
And you can see how good his pace is.
Yes.
Perfect for a team like Barca.
He scored a goal, what?
Yeah, he did.
What the fuck? Valencia, just letting you know. Yeah.
First team action?
Or something?
You know what's the best part about Paco?
You
know what's the best part about Paco? He had a 3-month goal drought.
Still having a drought.
Still continuing Barcelona.
Still having a drought.
So very unjustified lah of Barca.
It's just basically Barcelona being overconfident.
That's why Luis Enrique apologized lah later on.
He better, fucker.
He better.
But it was stupid. Like, there were a lot of missed chances as well from Barcelona.
Before we end the talk set, I want to talk about this as well. Now, isn't this a warning sign for you that Alaves scored a goal at late against Atletico Madrid to save a point? No. They weren't lucky.
I think that then you Leicester.
No, they basically. It was basically a point where their skills or luck temporarily exceeded that of.
So that for at that period of time they had steroids for a bit lah.
Yeah.
you want Anas Nano boost how Barca welcomed Brendan Rodgers to Champions League?
Man, that was a heartwarming welcome.
to Barca.
It was like 2-0 team during halftime. At least Celtic, you know, could have come back after the second half.
Yeah.
But fucker, wait, Enrique. Like, yeah, you know, so team like Sibai want to end that whole Champions League straight
since,
away.
Since we're talking about that already, let's go into it. Barcelona Celtic Champions League match. And okay, just to take note, this match happened on the
Wednesday morning,
Tuesday night. So we're only going to
this morning.
At the point of recording.
Barcelona played the usual Barcelona lah.
Yeah.
Rodgers team look like a Rodgers team.
This is Rodgers at the end.
I think the team showed character. We lost legit, 7 goals.
Okay. The back four don't know what they are doing because this is probably the first time they're going to play against Barcelona. Barcelona's fun tree.
Yeah, that's
together,
true.
MSN, together, MSN. Collectively.
MSN.
But for them to be that low, it's amazingly bad.
So imagine the places, you know, the players at the back for Celtic, right? They're not alert.
They're
making runs.
Right.
When they pass it, it's too late, really.
Mm.
Iniesta didn't play the first half, you know. It was, who was it? Gomez. Gomez played. Gomez.
It was Gomez, huh?
Gomez played first half. I was like, okay, they top off Iniesta. That was like, I mean, they didn't play Iniesta. They didn't play the whole full team, actually.
Which goes to show, Rodgers has not learned from his time in Liverpool. Yeah.
No. You know what, Rodgers?
I'm just kidding. He's not learned.
We need Alan.
We need Alan.
We need Alan.
Alan.
Alan to come down.
Seriously. No. It's actually quite obvious that he hasn't learned anything.
He hasn't learned anything.
He's employing the same tactics that he tried at Liverpool.
He's a beautiful human being.
But they beat Rangers 5-1
so?
In the Scottish Premier League.
So?
Exactly.
Scottish football, bro.
Which goes to the point. What the fuck? This is not good, you know. Celtic is like the best team in Scotland, but not the best team in the world in Europe.
When was the last time you saw a Scottish team qualify for a knockout?
In the 2008 Rangers. Yeah. Before they were sent to the third league. I remember, fucker, don't challenge me.
Well, actually, if I'm not mistaken, it was actually in 2010. It was also
It was quite early.
No, it was.
It's not Kenny Dalglish era. Okay.
It was also Celtic actually in 2010.
Kenny. It was not. Kenny
no, it was Rangers era, as well. Okay.
This Rangers. Is a new Brendan Rodgers team.
They came in the champions. Hey, we got Champions League, mate.
I'm looking forward to the Leicester game now.
I don't know how the fuck he's gonna hide your face, yo, after that game. He was just legit standing there chewing his gum.
Oh, Ranieri or Rodgers?
Rodgers had
he's
a
legit,
shit.
He lost his team lost 7-0 and he's standing there. Like,
you know, this is the biggest loss that had's apart from the 6-1 loss to Stoke that one fine day. Yeah.
I feel
this is worst loss in the career, I think.
Advice to Rodgers, probably you can go visit Thailand.
I was like, when I read about the loss, I was like, how can Rodgers get into this kind of teams that go into Champions League still?
Can Rodgers, man?
Actually,
he has not win anything.
No, I'm actually more wondering how
he will win.
He's still getting employed.
He will win the Scottish Premier League. That's one thing I can say. He will win the SPL. Yeah, that's yeah. because there's no challenge.
Roberto Martinez became Belgian manager.
Hoi.
Hey, and 1-3-0 against I can't remember who already, but they played well in the next game after they lost to Spain 2-0. Okay.
But it was like Rodgers team lah. Typical Rodgers.
Yeah, typical Rodgers.
Barcelona played
typical
their
Barcelona.
First team played Barcelona.
So guys, it's not just people who don't go to Liverpool they shit on Rodgers as well.
Hey, fuck you guys. Them chibai we all.
It's true, right? It's true.
But they
it's
had true.
One chance lah, Celtic. The penalty. just the gun block it. So legit. No consolation at all.
Moving on.
Let's show character.
Alright. So let's go back to the Spanish Premier League. That's it.
Oi!
Sorry.
That's enough on the Champions League for now. We're gonna go back into it later. But back to the Spanish Premier League. The next game that we covered was Valencia and Real Betis.
Yeah, I thought it was worth mentioning. We didn't talk about Valencia over the past two podcasts.
Got to talk a bit lah.
Here's a shocker for you. They are sitting at rock bottom right now.
Huh?
They have not earned
dun,
a point.
Dun, dun.
They have not earned a point at all so far.
Yeah, when I found out about this through Yuhan just now, I was very surprised by
it. Used to be the top four team.
Yeah. Used to be a Champions League team.
Mm. Yes.
Look at where they are now.
Rock bottom.
Wait, let's talk about what happened to them first. I'm going to ask all of you a question. Count the number of players from Valencia that have went to Barca.
Paco Alcacer.
Count the number.
I wouldn't want to say anything about
Now that we got that cleared off, you know, now that everything is cleared off. Why?
It's like this is like the whole Southampton Liverpool situation in the Spanish Premier League, you know.
Think about it. Why?
Dortmund situation as well.
Oh, yeah, Bayern Dortmund
situation. I mean, Mustafi went to Arsenal.
I'm gonna get to that later.
But the fucker's injured now.
Talk about why first. For one very simple reason.
Right.
I was reading The Sun this morning. It was not today's paper. I think it was a few days ago. They are heavily indebted. So indebted that they can't even afford to continue their renovations on their stadium.
Oh wow, that's fucked up.
Which is why they're selling off players. They are selling off players and getting in shitty replacements like Nani.
Benviedo. Right, Nani.
So I'm gonna rename the thing so that it's not just shitting at people shitting on Liverpool players, we're also shitting on ex-Manchester players.
Ah, damn. I did my research. They have incurred a total debt of 275 million euros in 2013.
Wow.
In 2013.
And they still haven't cleared the debt yet.
No.
Oh fuck.
Well, okay, this actually goes to show how much money, again, we've talked about this multiple times before, it goes to show how much money controls the game.
I agree. And other than that as well, that's one thing we can consider is public funding, which Valencia is not doing, but Catalonia is doing to Barcelona. You think
Catalans.
About it.
Catalans.
Yeah, the Catalans are doing something right for their team.
But it's really sad to see, they didn't exactly play bad in this game. Because even though they lose like Mustafi, okay, all these regular players, they were still relying on Parejo and Garay.
And but they did recently, okay, to
yeah,
be able
they
to.
They did try because it's a 2-3 at the end of the day. 2-3 to Valencia.
It was a hard fought victory for Real Betis.
Yeah, and they were quite unlucky. For Valencia. You know, luck wasn't on their side. So
how long will you?
I mean, it was what's his name? Is Ezequiel Garay and Daniel Parejo. They both had their chances. Both hit the woodwork.
Parejo was at number 10. Garay, they bought from Zenit St. Petersburg.
Yeah, but Garay used to be in Madrid.
Yeah, Garay used to be in Madrid.
Garay used
reject,
to be from Madrid.
Basically
yeah.
a reject.
He's a reject.
Yeah.
Madrid Jack. Okay.
okay.
Okay. Hey, surprising. Liverpool the one, man. Reject.
Oh, hey, fuck you lah. Fuck a damn rude way.
Technically we've been rejecting a lot of players for a cheaper price. So
no,
we're doing
no.
you guys a very good deal, okay?
No, Ian Iyer is not Klopp. Actually Klopp was so nice.
No, it's like we offer you
quite
players,
a
okay?
of players, but they bought Balotelli, Carroll.
Yeah, and we sold him for fucking free.
Legit leaf lah.
I like
leaf
how we talk about different leagues, right? But we always go back to our own teams. Our teams that we support.
Anyways,
for this podcast specifically, because it's quite fun to shit on them.
So fuck you guys. Can we hashtag Flashback Friday for this episode?
Tana, extra kerja. Alright, next up, we have Celta Vigo against Atletico Madrid.
Wow. Finally, Atletico, finally.
Tunjuk taring.
4-0.
4-0.
It was nice. Simeone changed his tactics. So instead of going for 4-4-2, he went for 4-3-3, and you can see the results. But it was nice. He didn't put 4 defensive midfielders anymore.
Yay.
Put Gabi, Sao Niguez, and Koke. Then he put Griezmann, Yannick Carrasco, and Torres up front.
Oh,
now, here's a surprising thing: Torres is not performing well.
Yeah, no, that's not surprising.
Not surprising, no.
Never.
What do you mean? What do you mean surprising?
I mean,
he played well when he came to Atletico
for one season.
Please, it wasn't even one season. Not throughout the whole season.
I am back home.
Throughout that whole season, he was up and down.
Yeah,
I want to talk about how Griezmann is crucial to them. Griezmann scored 2 headers, and
short
both were headers. For a short player like him. For a short player like him. It was a cross from Carrasco and I think Koke, if not mistaken. And then I don't know how he jumped. You need unbelievable force to be able to reach that high and score a header that powerful. It was nice.
Honestly, Griezmann himself, perhaps he's realised that he's been playing poorly. I wouldn't say shit, but poorly in the past few matches.
Or maybe he realised he will be relegated.
Yes, yes. Because he did say what if he like that,
maybe
he'd be relegated.
Maybe he fuck off lah.
Now I realize how fun it is.
No, maybe he realized that if he plays like shit, Arsenal's gonna buy him.
He's shit on his own team.
I won't say anything lah. Well, he might go to Arsenal. You know why? Because he's French.
Oh.
You are giving away Burns.
another like underwear model. Another underwear model.
Another underwear model.
Hey, I mean, you gotta be good looking enough to join Arsenal, right?
Okay, moving on.
But yeah, Atletico's performance overall was amazing in that game. And
yeah,
you could
it was
see
good.
The,
it was good.
The kind of plays that they can put out. And even if they had played like that, like if they can play like that against a team like Real Madrid or
Barcelona.
Yeah,
it's very attractive to see how they play long passes.
Exactly.
And they still not have players. Mm. Just steal the ball.
Yeah, and again, if they can play like that against Real Madrid or Barcelona, I'm pretty sure they can defeat them quite easily.
It'll be getting better for them, especially after they won, they defeated PSV in Champions League.
Yeah, and also, Nico Gaitan's not playing yet, so.
but they're going up against Bayern in Champions League.
They go up against Bayern later Arsenal pula.
Then you'll see Torres out of nowhere come song.
So he score a goal.
Scoring goals against Bayern.
Are they up against Bayern? I'm not sure. Just check the schedule.
Okay, they are going to be going against Bayern, it's not going to be easy for them. But if they can bring on this style of play, I don't see them not putting up a threat.
Speaking of Bayern.
Speaking of Bayern,
next up, we're done with the Spanish League. Okay, Spanish League, even though we were talking more about the English footballer. Spanish League, they were now going into the German League with the first game, which was Bayern Munich against Schalke.
Yay!
Oh, yeah!
And it was a game that was surprisingly good. Because Schalke themselves, they've not been doing that well over the past few years.
Right.
But they were actually playing really well against Bayern Munich in this game, despite losing 2-0. Because they actually had. I covered this game. And I saw the highlights. And they were pushing Barcelona back. They were pushing Bayern back to a point where they couldn't score until the 80th minute. And you can see how Bayern themselves, despite trying on and on over and over again, even with, Javi Martinez back.
Right.
They couldn't break through the defense.
That's surprising.
I think this is a question that I would ask. If Schalke played that well to only lose 2-0 to Bayern, how well do you have to play to defeat them?
That's a very good question.
City level.
You know, honestly speaking, right, even Barcelona would not
I don't
be
think
able
Barcelona
to beat
at
Bayern
this point
at this
of time
day.
Can defeat them.
No. Especially with Luis Enrique showing that he is able to fuck things up with even just a second team.
But again, true. But then let's talk about this, yeah? We're talking about a team like Schalke who have been really up and down, okay?
And someone that lost Sané.
Yeah, they lost Sané. Mm. But you saw players like, in that game itself, like you saw players like Konoplyanka playing really well in the wing.
Oh, Konoplyanka is in fucking Schalke now.
Yeah. Okay, do you remember?
Remember we wanted him in fucking Liverpool?
Don't say that, Henry!
Now he's in Schalke.
He's doing it before I do it.
Now he's in Schalke losing to Bayern Munich.
And then Schalke also had players like Huntala going all out.
And he's the type of guy that you can always rely on, even though he's old.
The thing about Huntala in that game was he had so many
Huntala.
Chances.
I never had Huntala.
But in that game, Huntala had so many chances, but he was a bit greedy.
How old is he? 100 years old?
Exactly.
He's that old.
He's probably that old already.
What the fuck?
No, I'm a Dutch fan, okay? I see Hunter play.
Same age like Bastian.
Huntala play like shit legit.
For which game?
For any game.
Oh, okay.
Legit, you put him. I mean, you want him to score goals, but he cannot score goals even in his national team. That's how sad it is.
He came very close lah.
Yeah.
Against Neuer.
Every time. Really close.
Neuer was part of Schalke.
Exactly.
You want to talk about how godly Neuer was?
No. Against Neuer.
You want to talk about how godly Neuer was in this game?
Or you want to say Kimmich? Or you want to talk about Kimmich?
He deserved the clean sheet, basically. Really deserved
the clean sheet. Neuer, when I was showing you
the
highlights.
He showed me a goal.
Sorry,
I think it was how many yards off?
Huntala around 45 yards.
45 yards out?
It was a good 45 yards out. Huntala tried, yeah? On target, the goal was saved by Neuer, just fingertip.
Ooh,
fingertip push, and then it went to the crossbar.
No keeper in the world would have been able to save that. Not even De Gea.
Not even Johar. Johar had a shitty debut in Torino.
Exactly at the corner. I don't know how the fuck he jumped. Probably used his penis to.
I want to say Mignolet can lah somewhere somehow.
Mignolet
sometimes
can
sometimes.
No. Mignolet can in FIFA lah.
No, if Mignolet did that jump right, he would hit the pole and go into coma.
So then he becomes the next Peter Cech.
I think Joshua Kimmich is one player that we talk, we criticize them a lot when he played Germany.
After Euros.
A man with very much talent.
What if he's rejuvenated because of
a shitty show in
of
Euros?
Ancelotti.
Oh.
That's an interesting point to see.
It's true.
Think about it.
It's true because remember when Kimmich was told off in front of everyone by Guardiola.
Yeah.
That time it hit such a big news. A lot of people were siding Guardiola for instilling like discipline to Kimmich, but then again, you have to understand that Kimmich is too young, so you can't always go hard on him.
Certain players are like that, lah. I mean, when you're younger, there are a few leeways you give to younger players.
That's true, but then
it comes to a point where. Are you really gonna give that leeway again? Are you really gonna keep up with that?
Mm. But it also goes to show that Kimmich has matured in the past few months, especially after going to Euros.
A man that can play any position apparently.
Still questions in my mind. Are you CK?
No, I'm just saying. He said that himself.
Okay. Yeah, you know what? In 6 months' time, they will be asking for Kimmich to come join Liverpool.
Shut up.
Oh no. Technically, Kimmich.
See, he's starting to think, can he fit in Liverpool? Actually, can,
I don't want Joshua Kimmich to come to Liverpool.
Actually, I want Johan to come to Liverpool and stop suffering in story, you know?
And then after he says, in 6 months' time, right, he will say, I'm glad he didn't come because Mario Götze was a case in point.
Speaking about Götze,
you know, this is a cue for you to rewind, right, Izham?
Fuck off, like, you guys. Speaking about Götze, let's go into the Red Bull game.
Red Bull.
What the fuck, man?
Even Leipzig.
Let's talk about the team.
Aren't they only in the first league, like the second season only?
Yep. And let's talk about the team. The only big team that's lost to Leipzig, lah.
Big Dortmund. Team. Since when Dortmund is a big team?
What are they then?
When Godzilla come over, it's not a big team. Eh?
It's fucking salty. I've let my past go, man.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Who's Mario Godzilla?
CK, you salty fuck.
Well, CK didn't take it with a pinch of salt.
But surprisingly,
took it with a tong.
Surprisingly, Götze played like someone. Okay, surprisingly,
someone where?
He played like
where?
Some
where? Someone who
like
what,
someone who Bayern would buy for 40 million instead of someone who returned to his former club for not making it in Bayern.
Playing defense, is it? So, go on. playing like Bayern, but couldn't score against a Red Bull team, huh? I don't know what to say.
We all don't know what to say because we're busy laughing from your statement.
Legit. Okay, Royce wasn't there, one thing.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say Royce was the whole thing, but I think Marco Royce and also Godzilla would.
And Aubameyang.
And Schürrle.
Really? If you put the front four like that, right? The front four like that, right?
Yeah,
it would be actually
Dembele.
Very dangerous.
Unfortunately.
Oh, and Ousmane Dembele.
Ousmane
Dembele.
So, it would be nice to watch, I feel. Dortmund is a very attacking team.
So, what happened to this game then?
Because one thing that I've noticed about this game, they both teams fielded their youth players.
Okay.
Not a bad thing, what?
Okay, CK.
Captain wasn't there. Dortmund has missed their captain.
Mats Hummels. He was missed.
Interesting point.
Because the season where Hummels was assigned captaincy, right, you could see how much of an aura he projected when playing with Dortmund.
Because when Dortmund was below, you know, at the relegation battle that time, who was the one that actually, you know, motivate the fans as
Hummels.
Well?
Hummels.
Was the
he
one.
Actually he, went over he there has, and said sorry. I remember that.
Leadership in that team.
I remember that.
But once he's gone, then the team at the back there
You can see them suffer.
Yes.
Definitely.
Papadopoulos is not exactly a good defender. He is good because Hummels was there to help him out.
Yeah.
But now he has Mark Bartra. Mark Bartra is still new to Dortmund.
Still very young.
So, you couldn't blame them for losing this game.
Partly to blame is because they didn't take initiative. It's Red Bull.
But if you're going up against the title race,
it's damn dangerous, you know.
Are obligated to win this kind of
matches. The only team that can actually race. Fight.
I think in the German league, there's never a race there.
But to be fair, if you had taken the 3 points from here, it would actually help you at the end of the race. You know?
Exactly, because really, you might regret not getting the 3 points here.
Every point counts.
Even now also.
Okay.
Bayern has won two games already.
Suddenly I feel salty about Liverpool.
Like Bayern,
you've always been salty about Liverpool, by the way.
Bayern has already won two games already. Dortmund already lost one. How long does it take for Bayern to lose a game? You never know what.
You'll never know.
You never know.
But all in all, yeah, guys, props to Leipzig for their historic win, lah.
Yeah,
historic win.
The Red Bull in them is just there,
lah. All right, so now we're going to go into our last talk set. Okay, we're going to be going into our Champions League pick of the week, which I did not pick, and I really don't want to talk about it, but we have to talk about it. Because you unpicked it.
Of course, I had to. Hey, every podcast you have to make fun of Arsenal. You can't make fun of Liverpool.
And I thought we were going to go through this podcast without even talking about Arsenal once.
Okay, Arsenal, thanks, I give them credit. Ospina played a very good
PSG
game.
PSG Arsenal game, just so you guys you guys know. Which they drew 1-1. Both of the teams drew 1-1. And I do agree with Siki on this. PSG did deserve to win.
What the fuck? PSG deserved to win.
Ospina?
Ospina really
man of the match. That surprised me the most because
in the second half,
In the second half.
In the first half,
Arsenal
PSG
was shit.
PSG was just trying all out, you know.
In the first half, Arsenal was shit. And Wenger noticed this. That's
Arsenal
why he
was always shit. That's why you asked there.
Even if he were always shit, like, this shit still was better than Liverpool.
If it's not ass, right, you cut off the
This shit is still better than Liverpool.
Okay.
But yeah, in the second half,
because they're in Champions League football, you know.
Yeah.
Just because they're in Champions League.
You guys mana? Tak nampak pun? Okay.
Tak apa.
See, this is why I'm keeping quiet, because
Tak berani.
Hey, how's Europa League to you guys?
Looks like a Champions League group to me.
But to be fair, I feel Chamberlain very questionable in that game. Doesn't attack that well.
I mean, okay, bar some of his headers and everything, as I said it before, he's been inconsistent. Dropped the whole time he's been there.
Why is he there? Why is he in Champions League?
I tak tahu lah.
Is it because he's the new generation of players and they need to expose him to this kind of fixtures?
I mean, it's a bit too late, right? Don't you think?
No. I mean, perhaps that is true because you're going to have to find a way to expose them one way or another.
It took Arsenal that long to expose Chamberlain. We know how good he is.
If you see that game, right, PSG was attacking at the right wing in here where Chamberlain and Monreal was.
Yeah.
Monreal was just like
Monreal. Okay, I blame Monreal on a point where he was too attack focused. He looped diri that he's also a defender. He wants
could
to be the next
Chamberlain
Wayne
wasn't
Rooney
there. There's no presence in the left.
No, Nacho wants to be the next Wayne Rooney lah. That's why they night turun.
Don't compare with Rooney lah, please. He's a different level, please. Ask Yuhan lah, you'll know.
I'm still gonna keep quiet.
Fucker, you put this game in, you talk with us.
Legit, PSG took Arsenal by surprise.
Aurier did really well. Okay, yeah. Aurier, he exploited Nacho.
Yeah,
and that's not to say Matuidi didn't exploit it on the other side also.
Hmm.
I'll tell you how many crosses that Aurier actually passed in for Cavani and also Matuidi. Mm, yeah.
That's true. And I also feel Mustafi still needs to build his chemistry with the team.
No, I have a question.
Mustafi's too injured. He's not playing enough.
Yeah.
No, is this PSG different after Ibra has left?
No.
I don't think.
You know, they are only gonna go downhill from here.
No, the thing about PSG. Even with Ibra there, I doubt it will be different.
With David Luiz gone, Ibra gone, other people, Verratti, probably gonna leave.
But props to Cavani, in that game.
Not really.
That's another guy who should leave as well.
He scored one goal, missed 1,000 chances.
Maybe his past few seasons has been overshadowed by Ibra's presence.
Yeah, it was.
It's finally his time to shine.
But
that is too long. Ask CK on this. I saw it also. The amount of goals he could have scored, I'm just glad he didn't.
I tell you, PSG could have ended the game so early.
With a second open goal that he missed.
Oh, he missed an open goal.
He beat Ospina, but he hit the post.
And then after he didn't even hit the post, he hit the side, I think. Then after that, ball by ball, Ospina was catching it.
Yeah, and he was falling down.
Basically, he missed the chance to score that goal that could have killed Arsenal.
Yeah.
Could have killed Arsenal.
And basically, Liverpool wants Ospina.
No, we don't.
We didn't even talk about Liverpool.
Hey, shut up. Bakarius wear two gloves already. That time you wear cast and play. Now you got two gloves already.
Hey, but so shout out to Giroud and Verratti. Thanks for the red cards, fuckers.
Yeah, it was like late drama, that one. So
fucking last minute drama.
It will be, I feel, that one that reflect. It was a very good volley, I feel.
Mm.
The ball straight come to him, and the keeper saved, PSG keeper saved the goal chance. That time deflected to Sanchez. I feel that goal was fucking lucky.
It was?
Out of nowhere.
It was, but I think about the goal as how Ibra scored during the Manchester derby.
Okay. So, I mean, like, without Sanchez, Arsenal is like shit like a Leo.
Hey, but also if you notice, Iwobi was having an okay game, yeah. Iwobi was,
yeah,
to I me, said, Iwobi was your, what's it called, pushing point for the game. He was the one that was always pushing
but
Arsenal.
But Chamberlain, what the fuck?
I cakap dah, kalau boleh aku nak jual Chamberlain atau Walcott dekat Newcastle.
Newcastle. Like Alex Hunter to Newcastle after he played for Manchester City. He played shit. If you guys don't know who Alex Hunter is, you guys need to play FIFA.
Alright, so that's it. We're done.
Woo!
We're done.
Yay. Huh.
Alright, so
thank you guys for having me in. I'm really sorry for not preparing.
With that being said,
should not even be fucking.
With that being said, like I said, we didn't cover all the UEFA Champions League. I'm bound to check
university.
Kepala aku tak
betul.
University. University.
The Champions League. Okay, we only covered the first day of matches. Mm. The second day of matches will be in our next podcast.
Yeah, I really look forward to how Leicester actually played.
Yeah, I think this will be a important match for Leicester.
Yeah,
and this coming weekend. Big match.
That big match coming up,
Merah lawan Biru. Merah lawan Biru.
Yeah, Liverpool versus Chelsea.
Oh, fuck.
Honestly. Let's do
score predictions.
Score predictions.
Let's do score predictions.
Okay, we haven't done this in a while,
2-0.
I'm saying 1-3.
1-3 to Chelsea. Okay.
I'm going to say 0-2 to Chelsea. Wow. Yeah. I don't see Klopp prevailing with this team against Conte.
I see Sadio Mane scoring one goal.
CK, how?
Fuck and man. Then Mignolet conceding two goals. It will not
Lucas,
be, it will not be the fault of the back four. It will be
Lucas
because of Mignolet.
CK, how? CK. Mana?
I'm calling it a 2-1 win for Liverpool.
Wow.
And I would say that it'd be a 0-3 win to Chelsea.
Wow, fuck you. Damn
rude
win.
It's a 3 against 1 though.
No, you gotta admit, Chelsea recently also have been really good and they've been doing amazing.
Then what happened to Swansea's game? Tell me.
Hey, that was unfair. That was unfair. It was injustice to them.
Injustice.
My social self came out. Sorry.
Injustice. I love the end of the podcast, man.
But I feel Liverpool should carry the momentum with having the new
main stand
exactly.
You know the sound from Anfield sounds so different right now. It feels
very
more powerful.
Yeah.
Johan, okay, they'll carry the momentum, but then Chelsea's gonna stop the momentum.
Yeah.
Fuck
lah. I can see that happening.
No, Chelsea doesn't have to stop the momentum. Mignolet will stop it.
But yeah,
if we win 4-3 to Arsenal and we lose 2-0 to Burnley, anything can happen, seriously.
Yeah, anything can happen.
You know what? I'm changing my scoreline 5-1.
5-1 to Chelsea. 5-1 to Chelsea. What? Oh,
it can happen, you know. CK.
No.
Well, it can happen for any match, okay?
5-1, I would say when they play City,
But I'll say money will be. I feel money will be the target man. I mean, for Chelsea, basically to mark that player, not letting him get through.
You tengok lah, money injured until lepas main Chelsea.
So we will have to see how Klopp goes around that game. I feel because Conte probably has some tricks in his mind. So
Henry's just playing his phone right now because he sees no hope anymore.
fuck you, Henry. You're a Liverpool fan.
I need to do work, lah.
And that's all for Sense of Pictures this week, guys. So make sure you guys follow us on our Facebook page, Sense of Pictures. And, YouTube channel, please subscribe lah. I mean, come on lah, we've been here for so long. We love you guys. Subscribe.
Please subscribe to us. We need money.
And we, just so you guys know, we also have a Twitter page.
Yes.
Yes.
The Sons of Pitches 4. Sons of Pitches 4.
Yes, because the first one got taken.
Hey, already. Okay. Also shout out to Selangor Champions League for having
yes,
us on.
Yes. Thank you so much for having Henry and I on.
Yes. I think it was a good exposure to the community league. If you want to look for it, it's at the Malaysian football team. Harimau
Malaysia. We'll link it down there. We'll link it down there. And whoever is uploading this, probably Henry is going to do that.
Hey, fuck you, lah. But it was seriously damn good exposure for us. We gained a lot of followers. Thank you so much for following Sons of Pitches.
And just so you guys know, this whole thing, it's not going to end just there.
Yeah. You will listen and you will be able to see Yuhan, CK, or the four of us one day punting together in the Champions League.
Yeah, but my dad is not an asshole.
Then that's not to say Carl won't be there. Carl from
Panabola Sepa. Thank you very much for actually calling us on as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you so much. We look forward to helping local football develop.
We really do. Yeah. We really do.
It is in our plans in the future. It won't be just international leagues.
Yes.
Yeah. We will definitely be paying attention to local.
Who knows? They might be coming up on this podcast. So
yeah, things are
make sure
up.
You guys listen to the podcast. Yeah.
Yeah. And follow us on YouTube. Thanks. Subscribe only.
Subscribe now. Alright, so that's all for Sensor Pitches. This is Ham.
This is Yuhan.
This is Henry.
This is CK.
Alright, we're gonna
beat Chelsea.
We're signing out. Goodbye.
I said it here.
Lots of balls.
Lots of balls. Lots of balls.